strip it back further and then do the same process.
So what is this?
This is the battery management system. Active balance. So that means that if one of the cells is lower than the rest of the cells, it will try to charge that single cell by itself to even it out. In theory, it's supposed to keep all of the cells at the exact same voltage and charge level. That way you don't overcharge or undercharge a single cell. I think I ordered it directly from HELTEC. And they have a bunch of different models, but this specific one, I needed 150 amp of amperage throughput and support a 16 cell bank. That's why I needed this specific model. We'll see how it goes. I got this from Harbor Freight. In the research I did for crimping big cables, which all of mine I use double aught, which is a really thick cable. In the research I did, this was the cheapest, reliable option that you could use, which so far it has proven up to the task. I've crimped all of the cables going to my battery, from my battery to the inverter, inverter to the fuse panel, as well as we just did some BMS or battery management system connection. So I've used it quite a bit. So far, so good. No complaints. I recommend. Yeah, that's right. Looks good to me. I am putting the tips on my battery management cable. Each one of these wires goes to one of the terminals on the battery so that it can monitor each cell. Since I've got two banks of 16 cells, I'm using 16 of these wires to monitor the voltage of each cell. I also have some, the same battery management also has a temperature sensor and some other stuff in it to make it to where it will automatically shut off if it's overcurrent or under temperature or something like this, something like that. So I just stripped a little bit of it back. Now I've got some big old sausage fingers, so doing this isn't that easy for me. So what I've been doing to make it a little easier is twisting it up a little bit, not too tight, but twisting it a little bit and then folding it over. And then that's how I've been putting it in there. So far it seems to work good enough. I know all the electronic guys are gonna be like, oh, it's supposed to be straight and causing resistance and all that. Well, the max amperage of this little cable is 1 amp. And actually it's less than that. So it's one volt, 1 amp basically, or like very low voltage and very low amperage. So I think it'll be all right. And I know I'm only supposed to clamp it once, but my, crimpers are a little janky, so that's what it is. And then I'm going to come back in with a heat gun and shrink these down, because I bought these which have heat shrink for the connect for the sheath part, so just to make it look a little cleaner. What I'm doing right now is I'm going through and loosening all of the positive terminals, because my battery management connects one line to all the positive terminals and then a line to one negative, and it reads the negative off of one because of the way it's wired. Hopefully I didn't just plug it wrong. I think I can only go in one spot. Top and one to the side or something, or down below maybe.